Like endless rain into a paper cup. They slither wildly as they slip away across the universe. Pools of sorrow.
Welcome to Salad Days.
Alright. Cool. Yeah. It's my Tarzan call, dog.
These guys are gay.
Hearty, man. Said, oh, God fucking damn, hearty. Oh my God, hearty. Hell yeah. All right.
All right, we have here the kit that I'm using to record Are You Serious. Consists of a couple different drum companies, Pegasus Percussion, which I use for my touring kit, and some of the things that Brian had here in the studio from Maryland Percussion, which is actually just located down the street.
Down below, we have the DW9000 double pedal with the felt side on the beater as opposed to the plastic side. Gives the kick drum a little boomier, less clicky, better control over dynamic sort of feel to it. And the Tama Iron Cobra hi-hat stand.
12, 8, 14, 16-inch toms, 24-inch kick drum, and a 14-inch snare drum. Variety of Sabian cymbals, HHX, AA, and AAX lines. 18-inch crashes on both sides, 16, 17-inch, instead of 14-inch accelerator hi-hat. The body is perforated for a little bit bigger sound out of the foot to cut through the mix a little bit more when you're timekeeping or just have some kind of crazy pattern going on with your left foot. 22-inch metal ride, very loud, very big, cuts through the mix very well as well. And a set of 13-inch auxiliary hi-hats on the right side for more blasts and thrash beats, so you don't have to cross over as much. As far as effects go, 18-inch ozone crash, very trashy, just very glassy sounding as opposed to straight up China or straight up thinner crash cymbal. And then the all important 18-inch HHX China Boy. Last but not least, for the guy that finally gets to join all the way up to me on stage, I have a letter.
After a while, taking influence from other forms of art, such as movies, for example, or books, becomes much more interesting when putting together musical projects. For example, this summer, for this record, for Are You Serious, I think we've taken a lot of influence from a few particular movies.
Tron, it's a sweet movie. That came out in 83 that I did not get a chance to see until this summer. My roommate Gene showed it to me. He's fucking crazy. Fucking listens to techno all day. Fucking crazy ass shit all the fucking time. But the feeling of the movie, like when you watch it in sections, especially in altered states of mind, the is fucking awesome. So, really like that movie.
Altered States, me and Logan kind of watched it towards the very end of the writing cycle, and it's kind of the last thing that influenced, well, maybe him for songwriting, I think, but it also influenced me a lot and pretty much everything that I do in my life from this point on. Basically, you just have to see it. A lot of you might not understand it, but it easily became my favorite movie of all time and affected me in a way that no movie ever has. I think it captures a little bit of what's going on this record, and at least for one, the lyrics to Brain Melter are definitely a little inspired by what goes on in that movie.
Fantastic Planet is also another one that, like him, was seriously sitting on the other side of the computer, afraid to watch the movie because of the music. The music is so fucking crazy. And like, everyone talks with a really fucking crazy ass voice, and like, I don't know. They just create a whole atmosphere of like alienness to the movie, which is really fucking awesome. And it's definitely like both of those movies have definitely played a huge role in like just shaping how I think about music and how I thought about music this summer, and they've gone on to form a lot of what this album's about, like the weird sounds and stuff. So definitely gonna check those movies out if you're into what you're hearing.